Jim Ross and Bobby the Brain Heenan back with you here for more WWF action. And as the Beverly Brothers and Little Louie make their way to the ring, I can't, I'll never forget seeing Bobby the Brain Heenan just last weekend holding on seemingly for dear life on this camel. It was something I'll never forget.
The worst day of my life. I was supposed to be taken out of the sedan. Feeding me grace, fanning me. They hooked me up to this 9,000-pound wild attack camel.
Attack camel?
You noticed it, too.
I didn't know that you had such a fear of animals.
I don't like camels. I don't even smoke.
You wouldn't have done well on the farm.
Of course not. From Beverly Hills. I don't have anything to do with farm animals.
Well, speaking of farm animals, and just about as crazy as something we have seen. Bobby the Brain Heenan and his adventures on his camel hide or something.
Hide? I don't know the camel thing. I don't want to talk about a camel. I don't like animals.
You know, Macho Man looked, I thought he looked very spectacular with the Vestal Virgins, and I don't understand what happened. I really thought, as you mentioned, that you were going to be with the Vestal Virgins.
Oh, I understand what happened. I was chopped one more time, stabbed in the back.
Were you a little bit intimidated by the Macho Man?
No, I don't get intimidated by him, but I'm not Marlon Perkins. I'm not an animal tamer. I'm not Siegfried Roy.
Tiger Jackson got a pretty nice haircut there.
What a lot of people don't know is Tiger Jackson, right there, is the first daughter of the Bushwhackers.
Would you please repeat that? I didn't really quite get that.
That is Luke and Butch's daughter.
Daughter?
That's what I hear.
Well, this one will be unorthodox to say the least. I don't envy the official in this match either. I don't know Botaya. And it looks as if Little Louie has a little size advantage. But not much.
But it looks like Tiger Jackson's a lot quicker. Matter of fact, Tiger Jackson looks like a cashew nut.
Sleight of hand. Speaking of sleight of hand, two going to clowns, and I don't care what you say, I saw two clowns.
See, that's what happens when you stay up late in Vegas. You'll see pink elephants if you stay up late enough. I'm telling you what it was. It was just an illusion, like Siegfried Roy do. It's a magic trick. There's only one doing it.
Well, I don't believe that. I think the fans who saw WrestleMania certainly would not agree with that either. Tiger Jackson seeking some relief there in the bottom turnbuckle.
I believe he was munched upon. You know what his favorite dessert is? Shortcake.
Shortcake. I had a feeling you might say that.
You know what his favorite seafood is? Shrimp.
Putting his slightly larger opponent down. Little unique assist there by the referee.
Throw him over here. I'll play catch with him.
He probably dropped him on purpose.
Accidents do happen, Ross. The world's smallest Chippendale dancer. He's quick.
Red face lock.
You know, if I bit that referee, I shove the referee, I'd be out of the WWF.
Again, the front face lock, and again, Tiger Jackson slapping the referee, and the referee thinks it was little Louie that was the perpetrator.
Tiger Jackson, dummy.
And you can certainly trust the Beverly brothers. They've never told a lie or done anything
not
illegal in their life. Well, you're the kind of guy, you know these guys. You guys are from the same part of the country.
Well, they're good friends of mine. They're from Ohio. They're from Shaker Heights outside of Cleveland. But they're wealthy. They're just nice people.
And the pace quickens there a little bit. Oops, you turn there by little Louie, and Tiger Jackson got tripped.
It's like a Nintendo game.
Tiger Jackson on his shoulder for that small airplane spin, and Louie's a little bit dizzy. Trips back over his opponent.
Come on, ref. Get Butch out of there.
There's an illegal assist by
Come
Butch.
On, ref.
And
it's going to win. That's not fair.
And the Beverly's now. And the Bushwhackers hooking it up. They were victorious in this contest.
They cheated. Butch came in and threw that little pantsuit.